Okay, in this session, I will talk about dimensions. What are dimensions? Dimensions are, as some people look at them, as a similar to a sub-account within your GL account list, your chart of accounts. I look at them as more like a tag. You're tagging the entries, your detailed entries, into your ledger, so that way you can do better analytical reporting, specifically around your profit and loss statements, your income statements. You could do analytic views of expenses, revenue, or the combination of the two. So let's take a look at how dimensions are set up in Business Central. I'm going to start by looking at the dimensions in this example. These are just examples. You get as many different dimensions as you want that's specific to your unit, your company. In this case, which is the most common, is department code. So in this case, my two buckets of dimensions are department codes and customer groups. So basically, departments is, as we go into an example of the values, the dimension values is, okay, I basically want to break out my departments by admin, production, and sales. So when I create an entry, whether it's a sales invoice or a purchase invoice or a GL entry, I could tag it with a specific department code. So in that way, when it comes time at the end of the month or any period of time, I could run a report broken down by department. I have another dimension group called customer group, which again, if I look at the values, I could create values of, in this case, I want to track all my large customers, medium customers, and small customers. So again, when I create a sales order, or a sales invoice, I'm going to tag it with what type of customer it is. So that way at the end of the month or at some period of time, I could look at all my revenue or look at a P&L broken down by large, medium, small companies. Okay, so here's an example of the dimensions and related dimension values. And again, these are all specific to your needs and what's important to you as a company to report on. I'm going to go into a setup just to show you as well in my general ledger setup. The dimensions, you'll see you have up to 8 dimensions that you can actually trigger and track. In theory, you could have more than that, but 8 is the setup max, and I would not probably recommend going over that because, again, it's a tag. So when you create entries, if you use all 8, that means you're entering an item or a GL account, and then you're tagging it with 8 other dimensions. So it could be overkill, if you will. So my experience, I limit it to 4 or 5 at the most. But here is, I just want, and you see that there's 2 global dimensions, which the global dimensions are globally throughout the system where you have easy access to them, in other words. Whereas a shortcut dimension works the same as far as analytic views and reporting capabilities, but they're not readily available, or they're available, but you may have to click on one or two other windows to access it. So it's not globally, robustly there at your fingertips. But reporting-wise, it all works the same. Let me show you what I mean. So once I set up those dimensions and my dimension values, and I decide whether they're global or shortcut, then I could start using them, right? So where could I use them? Like I said earlier, I could use them as a journal entry, on a sales order, or purchase order. Basically any transaction throughout the system. So for simplicity purposes, let's go through an easy example of a journal entry. So if I go into my journal entries, and I'm going to put in a posting date, I'll put in a document number, and I'm going to put in an expense account. And I'll just put in my expense dollar amount. And here is where I've got my two global dimensions. I got my department and customer group because I set them up to be my two dimensions. So now what I'm doing is I'm going to add a department code. I don't have to add a customer group code. I could if I want to get that additional information, but I don't need to. It's the dimension that's important for that transaction. And I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to add another one, and I'm going to offset it by revenue. And I will do 600. And the same thing. I could either have them go to the same accounts or I can mix and match, right? Obviously, typically it would be the same, but I'm just going to do this as an example. I could control what goes in there, but standardly I could choose whichever dimension and dimension values per transaction. So that's all. So now if you look, my journal entry is, I got a posting date, document number, my account number, which is my GL impact, with the associated dimensions. So I'm going to post this. Successful. That's good. And so if I go to my chart of accounts, and I'm going to scroll down to my accounts, and let's see, 4,200. If I drill down into details, you'll see now what it did is what makes up this value. I got a total of $670,000 in my sales. If I click on this, it's going to drill down into all the details, and you'll see all my detail lines, my transactions that got posted in the system, they either don't have a dimension code, or you'll see these are the tags, these are the dimensions that I put on in my journal entry. Remember my journal entry 123? I have a dimension code of product and small business. So now I have the ability to pull that data out and run reports off it based on these dimensions. Now you see there's a lot of them that don't have dimensions. We have controls in place where we could ensure that every transaction does in fact have a dimension. And we'll get back to that in a few minutes. Let me just show you another example, 602. I'm going to drill down to this expense. And there you have it. My journal entry, my offset to my expense, 123. Here's my GL account. And it went to my admin and large company for $600. So you see the advantage of using dimensions is purely for analytical information that you could pull out of the system at any given time and run analysis reports, whether it's just expense related, whether it's just revenue related, or you could actually have a full-fledged P&L statement broken down by dimension rather than just a general GL number. That's how the dimensions work. Now, to prove out, if I want to ensure that I always have a dimension code to my transaction, there is a setup here. If I go to Navigate Accounts Dimensions, this is where I could ensure that because it's an expense, I'm going to say for my dimension department, I want to make sure it's code mandatory. Or I can make it same code and same code. If I have a code mandatory, this means that I could have, I need a dimension. I don't care what dimension it is. As long as it's a department dimension, then that's what I will accept. Whereas if I have same code, then what this is showing you is that when I post a transaction to this GL account, 6022, then it's saying that it always has to be a dimension prod before you post it. If it's a different code than prod, it's going to error on you. Typically not used, but very well can be used. The more common is code mandatory. So that way, again, for dimension purposes, expenses could go to any department. So I don't care what department it is, just give me a department. That's being code mandatory. So again, now let me show you how that works. And I don't have to have customer group, because maybe customer group has nothing to do with expenses. So I could leave this blank, and I just want to ensure that I have department code only. So let me go back into my general ledger. And I'm going to do the same thing, 6022. And I'm going to do $400. And I'm going to skip department code. And I'm going to put in a customer group. Even though it's not needed, I'm still going to put that in. Okay, and then I'm just going to offset it by a revenue account. Now what happens if I leave this here? And let's just say I put this as prod. But what happens if I forget this? Well, when I think everything's good, my amount's good, my GL numbers are good, my date's good. And if I go to post this, it's going to give me an error saying that a department is needed for account 6022, 200, excuse me. So that way, that forces you, a user, to always make sure that if they accidentally missed a dimension, they know before it gets posted, they have to come back here and actually post or create a dimension in there. And now that the dimension's in there, post, and it goes through. So that's how you control dimension posting. So that way you ensure you always have a dimension code. You never have a blank dimension, is by leveraging code mandatory. Thanks for watching. If we could further assist you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.